try to answer the following questions yourself first, and then you can see to then you can use this video to see whether your answers are correct and whether you have included all steps. So, question A, we have a function f of z, determine the zeros of the numerator and the order, and question B, determine all the singularities of f of z and their type. So, let's start with question A. Okay, find the zeros. Well, we define the numerator as n of z equals z times z plus 1 squared. We can solve n of z equals 0, and you have the solution either z equals 0 or z equals minus 1. What about the order? Well, for that we need n prime of z as well, so we compute the derivative of n, use the product rule, we get z plus 1 squared plus 2 times z plus 1. Then we observe that the n prime of 0 is not equal to 0. N prime of 0 equals 1. So that means that 0 is a 0 of order 1, because n of 0 is 0, but n prime of 0 is not equal to 0. So then we know that 0 is a 0 of order 1. Now if you compute n prime of minus 1, you get 0. So you have n of minus 1 equals 0, and n prime of minus 1 equals 0. So you do not know the order of the 0 here yet. For that you need n double prime. Okay, let's compute n double. Then we get 2 times z plus 1 from this first term. Use product rule for the second one. So we get 2 times z plus 1 plus 2 times z. And if you plug in minus 1 now, you see those terms cancel out, but you get a minus 2 in particular. N double at minus 1 is not equal to 0. So that means that minus 1 is a 0 of order 2, because n of minus 1 equals 0, and prime of minus 1 is 0, but n double at minus 1 is not equal to 0. So there we have the zeros of the numerator. Question B. Singularities of f of z. Well, the denominator d of z equals sine squared of pi z. Well, both numerator and denominator are analytic, so f of z is analytic unless the denominator is equal to 0. So f of z is analytic unless d of z equals 0. So let's now find the zeros of the denominator. Well, d of z is 0 if and only if the sine of pi z equals 0. Well, you know the solutions in the real case, but complex case could in principle yield more solutions. So let's be a bit careful here when solving this equation. So the sine of z, here's the definition, it has to be equal to 0. So e to the power I pi z minus e to the power minus I pi z equals 0, or e to the power I pi z equals e to the power minus I pi z. Multiply left and right by e to the power I pi z, that yields e to the power 2 pi I z equals 1 equals e to the power 0. Now, e to the power alpha equals e to the power beta if and only if alpha equals beta plus k times 2 pi I. So that means that 2 pi I times z equals k times 2 pi I, where k is in z. So we have as our solutions z equals k, where k is in z. We have the zeros of the denominator. If we want to determine the type of the singularities, we also need the order of the zeros of the denominator. So we use a similar approach as in part A. We have d of z over here. We compute d prime first. So d prime yields pi times 2 times sine times cosine. It's pi of z's argument. Now if k is in z, we still have this sine pi z, so d prime at k is still 0. So we also need a second derivative. For d double, we get 2 pi and pi from an additional chain factor, and then differentiate sine and leave cosine, gives you cosine times cosine, and leave a sine and differentiate the cosine yields a minus sine squared. So there we have d double. Now, in z equals k, the second part still drops out, but you have a cosine squared pi z, which is equal to 1, so that d double equals 2 pi squared is non-zero in k. So you have d of k equals 0, d prime of k equals 0, and d double is not equal to 0. That means that k is a 0 of order 2 of d of z. Now, what are the singularities? If z equals 0, so k equals 0, we have a 0 of order 1 of the numerator, of order 2 of the denominator. So we're left with a 0 of order 1 in the denominator. So we have a pole of order 1 if z equals 0. If z equals minus 1, k equals minus 1, z equals minus 1, we have a 0 of order 2 in the numerator, a 0 of order 2 in the denominator. So those cancel out. So at z equals minus 1, we have a so-called removable singularity. What happens for all the other k? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and minus 2, minus 3, etc. So what happens for z equals k? K is not 0 or not minus 1. The numerator is not 0. The denominator has a 0 of order 2, which means that we have a pole of order 2 in all those cases. So there we have all singularities of f of z and their type.